The yellow glow of bright shining wood holding up the structures of this buzzing atmosphere. It provides the foundations of a sunny setting where the girls dance and bring everything to life. I feel myself slipping into a warm euphoric glow at the end of hapless dilemmas created by rationale. As the grass glides in the summer breeze like high definition and slow motion dreamscapes of shapes bristling with life. I feel like I know every face in this vague yet shiny mystic landscape, but I don't, and I don't even know where I am. Is this really happening? Suddenly, I'm brought back into the orange radiating cylindrical halo of comfort when I hear a divine voice so feminine and gentle. I hear not what she says, only the high-pitched frequency that shocks me with waves of comfort traveling down my spine with a warm resonating feeling of release. Release of tension and brings me into a feeling of knowing exactly who I am. As we sit down on the soft, thin yet solid netting of the basket-like chairs, illuminated by the sunshine rays reflecting the white sand-covered ground, infiltrated in a slow and steady rhythm of light blue liquid waves sinking and turning it into a combination of liquid and solid shape. Back inside I see white painted rock walls decorated with green leaves waving around, gaining my attention via my peripherals, as if to tell me that I am not the only one enjoying this alien world creation. Alien yet so familiar, as it is just a projection of my subconscious. I sit with a divine beauty drinking wine that doesn't make me sick and smoking cigarettes that won't give me cancer. I don't know what we are talking about, but I feel there in the moment, which is 90% of the battle. I am joined by more goddesses who enter this white leather lounge glass table setting from the side as though they were always there, but somehow I hadn't noticed. Probably because I'm so into what is happening in front of me. Each one with drink in hand surrounds me in this indoor-outdoor beach shack with fans hanging down from the invisible ceiling generating waves of air, pushing their long strands of hair from side to side, impacting me deeper than I care to show as we chat and smoke. But I am blown away. How could anything ever be so perfect in all its complexities? Locked in this external circus of laughter and twisting rides of conversations, the sky slowly darkens as the great ball of light waves us goodbye in style, saluted by the ocean horizon of blue changing from deep purple to light pink and then a fragile white as it reflects our new hero. The white glowing full moon presents itself as the mood turns from one of relaxation to endless possibility and excitement of events that will take place throughout the night in this fire-lit scene of walls changing color, bouncing to the electronic synthesizers and saxophones in sync with each other. We become the bass that creates the other half of the atmosphere. The laughter has progressed to rhythmic dancing. Twisting and moving are the tight fabric dresses in a way that could only be generated by pure soul and never by a machine or falsely presented identity. Moods turning intimate as eyes lock in indescribable and lustful connection of knowing thy other half. Recognition of similarity on the dance floor as we partake in rhythmic flow of touch and again, that omnipresent recognition. Recognition that yes, this girl is just like me. This scene faintly disappears, progressively fading away as I drift toward the night sky, looking down on that blue-green neon-lit and basket-woven shack and the shadows of these uniquely humane movements in sync with the 1-4 beat. I float into a wave of blackness throwing itself around me as everything visible disappears. Away I drift, alone in my journey with the constantly reminding sound of those sky-reflecting waves crashing over the mystic widespread shore that I will never set foot again. From this event and memory I leave with a new strength and confidence in my existence, as that was the day where I felt truly present. I felt in the moment, and now I await the next multicolored collage of sound, women, and conversation that will present itself to me. Maybe in a sunny fire and neon lit setting, or maybe in a completely different place such as the desert or space. Who knows? It will be a time and place that dictates how I feel, instead of the voice in my head dictating how I feel.